Hi learners, in this video I'm going to talk about corporate social responsibility. Corporate social responsibility basically refers to the activities which is undertaken by the companies in order to promote the well-being of the society. Now, since most business houses, okay, they conduct the business in a society and they draw their profits from the society. So in return, they have to contribute a portion of the profits back towards the welfare of the society. So CSR is an activity in clearing this social debt. Now, there are various activities which can be called as, which the companies can adopt in order to discharge corporate social responsibility towards the society, such as developing educational institutions, sponsoring sports events, participating in healthcare activities, maintaining parks, then, providing digital education to people, and then promoting education in rural areas and a host of other activities. So basically, to promote corporate social responsibility, under the Companies Act of 2013, there have been changes made, okay? And corporate social responsibility has been incorporated under the Companies Act Amendment in 2013. Now, these are, as per the Act, the first thing which the Act aims at is establishing a CSR committee in the companies. Now, this CSR committee is responsible for looking after the corporate social responsibility activities of the company. So this CSR committee performs a host of functions, like they are responsible for framing the corporate social responsibility policy formulation. Then after the policy has been formed, okay, in the policy they will outline the activities which the company will undertake in order to promote the welfare of the society. Then the making of budgets and the allocation of amounts for corporate social responsibility activities is also the responsibility of the CSR committee. Then as per the Companies Act of Amendment Act of 2013, Schedule 7 specifies the following CSR activities. The first CSR activity is environmental sustainability. Environmental sustainability here means all the activities which is undertaken by the company in order to promote environmental sustainability. Like we have this Bharat Petroleum Corporation Limited. So this BPCL, okay, tries to maintain one of its CSR initiatives is maintaining of sanitation facilities and health management, okay. And this initiative has been carried out since a long time by the BPCL. Next, we have empowering women. Empowering women basically refers to imparting education facilities to women, then giving them training in certain special skills so that they become financially independent. You have example of this could be Mahindra and Mahindra company. It has started a project, okay, since a long time, which is called as Project Nanhi Kali. In this project, it basically aims at educating girls so that they become financially independent. Then finally, CSR activities are also aimed at enhancing education levels in almost all the states. Poverty reduction and eradicating hunger. Okay, so here this CSR activity basically aims at reducing, improving the financial status of the people and reducing the poverty levels in the country. And eradicating hunger basically means to make sure, that free meals are provided in areas where we have people suffering from, people dying from hunger. Then social business projects means there are certain, these are projects where, widowed women or single mothers, they'll be given training in certain special skills, like in handicrafts or in garment industries, and they'll be provided with employment. Okay, so such social business projects are also undertaken by the business houses. One such example is about Ambuja Cement, okay, which it conducts social business projects, okay, basically with the aim to energize, involve and enable communities to develop their potential and provide them with employment. Then next we have is reducing child mortality. This means child birth rate, children dying at a young age, basically infants dying, okay? And improving maternal health, okay? Now, improving maternal health is due to due to deliveries, we find that many women are losing their lives during the birth process. So this basically aims at improving the maternal health so that women can easily, women can come out of the birth process in a healthy way. Next we have is improving health services. Almost most of the companies are engaged in improving health services, and especially because of the pandemic of COVID-19, okay, most of the companies have been conducting lots of CSR initiatives in order to improve the health services. One such example is Tata Chemicals, okay, which tops the list of CSR activities in India. since lockdown, okay, Tata Chemicals has been engaged in providing medical help, in providing sanitizers, health masks, I mean face masks to people and all that. So that this is also one of the types of CSR initiatives which is taken by Tata Chemicals. Next is we have this importing of vocational skills. Vocational skills is basically providing skills to people not through formal education but informally. Okay, so basically providing skills in hand making of handicrafts, handlooms, all this comes under importing of vocational skills. Okay, and teaching people how to do typewriting and all so that they become employable is also a part of importing vocational skills. So basically all these activities becomes a part of CSR activities. Further, the next function of CSR committee is, it should give preference to the local area where they are operating in their CSR activities. So supposing the company is operating in Delhi, they should focus on CSR activities first in Delhi and then in other states. Next we have is the committee should follow guidelines given in the company's rules of 2014. Now in the company's rules of 2014 contains a list of what all CSR activities have to be undertaken, how the procedure has to be followed in imparting corporate social responsibility activities. So basically the committee should follow the guidelines which is given in the company rules. Then only CSR activities undertaken in India would be considered as eligible for claiming tax deduction rebates and all that. Okay, so basically these are some of the functions of the corporate social responsibility committees which is set up under section 135.